My hands are going to get in the way a little bit, but I got to clean off some of this to try to fit this better.
No, wait.
Okay, that looks pretty good. Yeah. Now I gotta work on this other side. I can move you, hold on. Okay. That's pretty good. We have to measure. This way. I want to measure on the top. And I'm at 39. And if I measure from this side to the top, I'm at 39 and a 3/16, maybe a quarter. So we can try a couple things. We can go. Which way do we want to go? We're gonna go that way. So we come in. Yeah. And we're at 39 1/16, and 39 1/8, over 16th, 39 1/16. So we're pretty damn close on that shit. Right? Now what we gotta do is get them vertical. See, so we're off again. So we gotta come this way or go in some. And whew, we're getting closer. I'm not touching on the outside yet. Getting closer. I want to give it a big old whack and see what happens. That is almost there. I gotta come this way on the top side. I don't need something right here. And I only have like a teeny tiny bit of space. Oh shit! Oh yeah. Boom, Bob's your uncle. I actually got room to go back. So we do that. And then we got to remeasure for square. And I'm at 38 and 7/8. And 38 and 7/8. Try that again. Oh shit. 38 and 7/8. Okay. So we're level up and down, and we're square side to side. Right? So if we back it up, then these things are straight going this away, and they're straight going that away. That's pretty cool. And so if we look at the top, it curves a little bit, but if we look at the bottom, it's flush. Top curves, bottom flush. I think what I'm going to do after I get this snugged up is I'm going to weld it. That way it won't walk at all. I got a good spot right here on the edge, and then along the top, along the side over there. But first we got to bolt it into place. There's going to be a lot to do. So bolt it into place. Got to drill these holes. Bolt it in place. To snug it. Then we have to come back. Clean our edges. Weld. And that's going to burn off all the paint again. And then we'll have to come back and repaint with more Pour 15. And those are going to be all right. This one has a little divot in it. I may have to put a piece in there to make it match, because that kind of bothers me. See how this one's straight? This one I was cutting and I cut too far over. But I can put a piece back in there. I got some scrap right here. I can fill that. So what they say to do is clamp and drill. And then there's another one on the bottom I gotta drill. So there's three bolts on top, three bolts on the bottom, each side. So I bought these bits. They're basically disposable. I should punch that. I got a step bit. Oh, not quite. Gotta go one more level. Boom. So in theory, I could tighten these up and then drill that hole.
So do you want to wait to weld it until it's mocked up?
Yes.
That way we can adjust.
Yes.
These are for the track part?
Yes. Four links. These are for the four links. But before I started drilling, everything matched.
It still matches. Looks like it does.
Well, yeah. Looks like it does. But we gotta measure and shit. Gotta remeasure, readjust, retighten.
Did you have to bust out this others?
Yeah, it's sitting right on top of it.
You got a couple more cross members going on, right?
We have the cross member for the
transmission. And then we're putting, we're welding this in.
Yeah, gets bolted in well. There's not a lot of space. Yeah. I need a midget bodybuilder.
I got it.
Your hands are fat like fucking.
Thanks.
Bigfoot.
Thank you.
Well, if the bolt snaps, it's too tight. Right?
Oh my god. There's gotta be torque specs on that shit.
Oh, I'm gonna say torque spec on that's probably 50 pounds.
Oh, yeah. Probably so. Do it.
38.
Yeah, we're working on 7/8. Chevy.
38 7/8. It's fucking bomb. Check for this. Look at that. Can you see that? There we go. That's good. So, clamp and drill the other side.